Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement multi-level inheritance in C++. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow my YouTube channel, that is Sanjay_Gupta_TechSchool. You can download my app TechMS based on programming languages, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic, in this video, I am going to demonstrate you the use of multi-level inheritance in C++. For that purpose, I have included a header file iostream. Then I have used a namespace std. First class is person, second will be student, and third class will be employee. So in case of multi-level inheritance, first class will be inherited into second class will be inherited into third class, and so on. And at last, the last derived class object will be created, which will be calling members of all the base classes which are defined above that derived class. So here, first I have implemented person class, which is containing two attributes, id and name. Then through read function, id and names are received, and through print function, these id and names will be displayed on console. Then person class is inherited into student class. So student class is derived class for person class. It has two attributes, roll number and branch. Then its read function is first calling read function of person class, because person class is base class for student class. Then roll number and branch of student will be received. Inside print function of student class, print function of person class is called first, and then roll number and branch are displayed using cout statement. Now for employee class, student class is base class. So base class and student class and person class both are inherited into employee class, because student is inheriting person class. So employee base class is student class, and student base class is person class. So with this hierarchy, multi-level inheritance can be implemented in C++. Here designation and salary are attributes of employee class. Then inside read function of employee class, read function of student class is called. So this will call read function of student class. Further, student class read function will call read function of person class. Then designation and salary of employee is received. Inside print function, student class print function is called. Then designation and salary is displayed using cout. At last, main function is implemented. Here only last derived class object will be created. So I have created e object of employee class, which is calling read and print function of employee class. So employee class read and print functions are calling read and print of student, and student class read and print functions are calling read and print of person class. So all the read and print functions will be called through this single object. This is the advantage of multi-level inheritance. Now I am executing this code. You can see it is asking for ID, then name, then roll number, then branch, then designation. And then salary. You can see all the outputs, ID, name, roll number, branch, designation, and salary. All these information are received and displayed using read and print functions of all the classes. And all the read and print functions are called through a single object, which belongs to employee class. So this is the demonstration of multi-level inheritance in C++. I hope you have understood how we can implement this concept. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow my YouTube channel, that is Sanjay_Gupta_TechSchool. You can also download my app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.